Dean of Auro University, Dr. Kiran Singh, and my colleagues in the university, and of course, all the audience, those who are present in this webinar. Friends, the change is rapid and massive, as we have seen since last two decades. After corona virus, after COVID-19, the world will be much, much different than what used to be. And we need to look at it from two angles. One is the challenges which we are going to face, but at the same time, we also need to look at it as an opportunity. The moment if we look at it as an opportunity, then we will be able to transform the higher education in our country. And I am sure if we work together, we will be able to. All across the globe, there are 1.5 billion young people, those who are studying in schools and colleges. Now, we need to fulfill the promises of this 1.5 billion young people across the globe. If we think of ourselves, then let us think of our own university, our own state, and our own nation. And I'm sure we will think from all these point of view. In the last two decades and before that, in the 20th century, the whole education system was based on transferring the knowledge, to which I call it as known knowns. We were working in the field of known knowns and transferring that to these young people. Then later it came in the 21st century. At the beginning of the 21st century, in the first decade, we started talking about entering into the world of known unknowns. But friends, the disaster which came because of this COVID-19 is forcing us to look at this education system as a whole from the unknown unknown point of view. You have seen this COVID-19. It is unknown unknown. The whole world don't know what exactly needs to be done, how this virus is going to behave, whether there will be a second time this will come again or not. So a lot of research is going on, and therefore in the entire lifetime of ours and the future generations, we will have to work in the arena of unknown unknowns. And if we understand what unknown unknowns are, then we will have to think what kind of education system which we need to, even in terms of research. Research we do for publishing papers in the research journals or for the patents. Let me tell you that 85% of the patents in the entire world, they are on papers. They are of no use to the community. Through the research journals, whatever papers we are publishing, they are of use to us only, but not to the community. And therefore, we need to design a policy. Of course, when Madam is there, we will certainly get many more policies, as the government of Gujarat is already doing some innovations. Can we design a policy of responsible research and innovation? Any research we do, it has to be a responsible research. We need to use all the tools that today we are talking about digitization. A lot of progress has been made in last so many years. But today we need to understand the rural folks, they don't have the connectivity. And therefore, the Auro University is working on a solution that may work even in interrupted connectivity. You don't need a very big bandwidth. Even if you don't have internet, even in rural areas, we can reach out with a concept, with a vibrant context and vibrant content. That is the technology with which Auro University is working. So our examinations will be done this time using artificial intelligence. Even one can appear on mobile, where you can know what the student is doing at that end, what the learner is doing, for which we are using artificial intelligence. This is where we need to move and we need to find some solutions. lastly, I must say, I call it as saral. हमको ये सारे प्रश्नों के उत्तर सरलता से ढूंढने हैं. सरल इज एस ए आर ए एल. आई टॉक अबाउट सरल क्यूब. नाउ सरल क्यूब इज एस स्टैंड फॉर स्किल्स. वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द फ्यूचर स्किल्स वी नीड टू इम्पार्ट टू अवर स्टूडेंट्स एंड दैट नीड्स टू बी इंटीग्रेटेड इन टू अवर करिकुलम. द सोशल इंटेलिजेंस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द सोसाइटी. And therefore, second S is social intelligence. The third S is spiritual quotient and the sensitivity. A cube stands for access, affordability, and accountability. Accountability is very, very important. Second A cube stands for anytime, anywhere, anybody should be able to get this education, should get the opportunity of learning. Nobody can be left out. L cube stands for lifelong learning. We need to understand. We have to learn throughout life. Say, since last 2 months, I am online and I have only mobile. There is no issue with me. The R cube, R stands for rigor, rigor in academics. Then it has to be responsible. We must empower students to take charge of their life. We need to make them responsible, and of course, whatever we do, it has to be relevant all the time. And we need to understand what resilience means. This COVID-19, post-COVID-19 is teaching us the resilient education system, where we are talking about compassionate education also. And therefore, friends, working in isolation is not going to help. We need to work in partnership. As universities are working in isolation, I feel all the universities and educational institutions and government should come together and work together. Then only we will be able to learn to live together. And that is going to provide us the solution. So, Auro University has done so much, and we are using all the disruptor kind of education, disruptor technologies into our Auro University, and our education system in Auro is resilient one, which will be future industry ready. That is what we are concentrating at present in our university. I am sure with the guidance and help of Madam Anju Sharma, the Honorable at Principal Secretary of Government of Gujarat and the Government of Gujarat, we will move ahead. Thank you. Thank you very much. And once again, I thank Madam for giving us the time.
Thank you for your address, sir. Before we begin, I would like to encourage all in the audience to participate today by asking questions. To do so, please type questions in chat box at any time during the talk. We'll keep the track of all questions and share them at the end of the webinar. And now, ma'am, may I please request you to address our audience.
Namaskar. All the participants of this webinar, Vice Chancellor of Auro University, Sri Rajanji, Dr. Rohit Singh, and all the eminent viewers. We are meeting in the times of COVID, when so many questions have come up, and as Dr. Rajan said, the unknown, and we always talked of known unknown and unknown known. This was unknown. Yes, we never expected that this kind of thing would happen, and what would happen if this kind of thing did happen. So it turned out to be quite a difficult situation for us, and we are still probably not able to recover fully from it and not able to visualize a normal life. And that's why all these questions are now coming up. What's going to be the future of higher education, and how the entire landscape of education, why only education, the entire landscape of life is going to be in the coming days. Let me first start here with the premise that thinking that things are going to remain this way that they are right now will not take us anywhere, because human beings have a great tendency to be resilient, so of resurgence, and they have got great capacity to do that. They have always found ways out, and they have always coped up with the various kind of problems that have come up of varying magnitudes. Right from a time where it was an ashram kind of education, Gurukul kind of education, where children would learn sitting at the feet of the guru. And now in the forests and in the ashrams and all, we have come to an age where we teach them in classes of hundreds, and there is no personal touch. It's only a very, very kind of very impersonal kind of education in certain institutions. At that time, I think Auro University is really making a difference, because they have gone back to Sri Aurobindo's methods of teaching, and they have tried to bring together the values related to education, the values relating to learning, and the personal touch in the field of education, and developing not only the intellect of the student, but also the spiritual quotient of the student. With that in background, if we think that technology is going to solve all our problems, that's my personal opinion, that's not going to. Of course, with the experience of COVID, not because of anything else, but because of now our familiarity with technology, something like conducting a webinar or holding a web class was like kind of unthinkable for many people. Like even I was not, you know, I would hardly do a video conference because I had that camera shyness. But now it's a routine thing. So you are doing 5 video conferences every day. Sometimes I have addressed up to 5 also. So it has become a very routine, and we have found that it is a very convenient way of doing things. So we can do it. But we'll have to accept that it is not the most effective method of learning. Yes, it is the most convenient method of learning, the safest method of learning in the COVID times, but it is not the most effective. The best learning would still come only with a person-to-person interaction, with a person-to-person learning, which is based on a lot of interaction, a lot of question-answer, a lot of personal involvement between the teacher and the student. That's not going to go away, but we have to find a way out. So certainly, things are going to change. We'll have more and more proportion of online inputs. Everything that can go online will be going online. That's what I see. And everything that cannot will remain in the physical realm. See, as it is, because so many questions are now being asked about the quality of the class of 2020 and the class of 2021. Students have been asking, give us mass promotion, don't take any examination, just promote us. Now, they don't understand that when they go in the job market, and even after 10 years, and when there is in the mark sheet, it comes batch of class of 2020 or the class of 2021. That's going to have an impact on their employer. Oh, you belong to 2020, that time no examinations took place, you were not even tested. And so a question mark comes. So that question mark has to be avoided. That stigma has to be avoided. That no. So that's why we decided that for final year examination, yes, exams have to be taken. Students have to study, and that gives them a brand, that gives them a certification that yes, you are there because you are there, because you deserve to be there. So education is not a system of churning out degrees and churning out certificates. It's not that. In fact, personally, as a parent, if I am told, would you like to have a substandard academic session or take a 1 year drop for my own son, I would prefer the latter. Like, go for 1 year drop. I don't want any substandard learning for my son. because 1 year can always be caught up in this 70-75 years of life. But a substandard learning stays with you throughout. So would I want to carry a baggage of substandard learning all through my life? For anyone who's in their 20s, it's about 50 years or so. Or you just say, okay, 1 year, I'm fine with it. I'll take it next year. That thing, that extreme thing, by God's grace, is not going to happen because we are finding ways. But I'm telling the extreme scenario, what I would prefer as a parent, not everybody would prefer. They may say that each and every month is important to us. Each and every year is important to us. But yes, each and every year of post-learning is also important for us. So we have to weigh our costs and benefits. And that's what we're doing. We're trying to have a situation where we can have the maximum benefit in minimum cost. So we are now looking at, and our universities are also looking at newer models of learning where minimum disadvantage is suffered by the students and they get the maximum benefit of learning. So it would mean a lot of hybrid methods of learning that I anticipate. Also, it would mean smaller classes. Because with a lot of social distancing coming in, actually it's not social distancing, it's physical distancing. Social distancing is when we distance each other socially, or physical distancing. So with a lot of physical distancing criteria coming in between, the classes will have to be smaller. The classes would mean like the batch size, so that you can accommodate in the group everybody. And a lot of hybrid learning will happen there. Okay, this part can go to online learning, let it go there. This part cannot be done with online learning, let it stay here. So that we have to optimize our time. And also a lot of focus on doing it at home. What can be done at home should be done at home. What need to be brought to the institution should be brought to the institution. What you can do sitting in the hostel room, do it there. What you need to bring to the institution, what you need to come to the institution, come to that. So that the exposure gets reduced, minimized. And plus a lot of artificial intelligence also, which can give us tools to measure the learning process can be then tweaked, can be moderated as per the demands of the learner. If the learner is here, okay, learning is here. If the learner is here, the learning is here. And that's, I think, also a problem of the current education system. We give the same food to everybody, diabetic also, obese also, starved also, the very thin person also, all kind of people are there in the classroom with different mental level. So that's why I said, we don't care whether it's diabetes, we give the same food. It's not going to work. There is a class is diverse. We have to build in methods of individual variation, adapting the learning process to the requirements of the individual learners. So that wherever necessary, the changes can be made. And that's what actually a good teacher does. When they are interacting with the students, they try to moderate these differences in the class. Give more to the person who needs more, give less to the person who needs less. Give more difficult content to the person who can absorb it, less difficult to the person who cannot. With, yes, of course, a baseline so that everybody is there at the baseline. But then artificial intelligence will have a very important role to play in this entire process, in modifying the content on the basis of the needs of the individual. So bringing a match between the learning, content, pedagogy, content and the individual needs. So on that, a lot I anticipate that it will go. Yes, this year is going to be a tough year. Coming year is going to be tough year. In fact, I read one article in which they said that the class of 2020 is the most unfortunate class, and I can understand, because people would think of their something which you dream of, you know, as soon as you enter the campus, you start dreaming about your graduation day, when you will be given graduation, and when you will don the robe, and you will fly off your cap, and you will say goodbyes to everybody. You will have, you'll be hanging out with friends. Your parents will come on the graduation day. All that didn't happen. All that didn't happen. It's not going to happen also. And that's what the class of 2020 has learned as a lesson in life, that things may not go in life as you expect them to be. So better accept. So since you cannot, it's not going as per your expectation, you accept it. So that's what is the biggest learning for 2020. And for 2021, it's going to be still a bigger learning, that you have to rise up to the occasion. You have to ensure that in the most adverse situations also, you are able to catch up, because it's going to be difficult for them. Considering the current situation, we don't even know when the regular academic sessions would start. Considering the present situation, we don't even know whether it will be a full year, or it will be a half year, or it will be what. At this moment, it's very difficult to, if we can just have a hazy picture, it's very difficult to say with most certainty that this is going to be like that. So we have to, at this time, it's the values of our, the spiritual values will come to our rescue. Accept, be resilient, understand the situation, understand that nothing is certain. You have to adjust to the situation. You have to make the best out of the situation. You have to respond to the situation as and when it comes, and move with a focus, and also not lose yourself in the process. The biggest thing is losing yourself in the process. And when one loses herself or himself, it's the worst thing that can happen. And that's the most important thing. Whatever is gone, it's gone. Whatever is coming, will come. You do not have any control on either. It's totally out of control. Whatever happened, it was never in your hands. Had anyone even thought on 28th of February that it's going to be like this? No. And what do you know what's going to happen next? Whatever is coming will come. And whatever has gone, this is the only way it would have happened. No regrets, just acceptance. These are the values that are going to come to our rescue during all these uncertain time humanity is passing through, the greatest uncertain time of the last 50 years. And we all have to struggle together to make sure that we emerge victorious, and we emerge as a fully integrated, well-educated and well-evolved person, and we grow through this entire pandemic. Thanks for giving me a patient hearing, and thanks for organizing this beautiful webinar. Thank you so much.
In Shakespeare, it is said that readiness is all, and we are getting ready for future also. So thank you so much. I request Rohitji to say word of thanks. Rohitji, please.
Thank you, Anju ma'am. Thank you so much for sparing your valuable time and coming on with Aura University for the 100th webinar of the Aura University webinar series. I totally agree, and I just let the audience that there's a book by ma'am which we have forgot to mention, The Corporate Monk. If you read that book, you will get the insights what ma'am is trying to also relate to the unknown, from the known, and from unknown to the unknown. I totally agree with ma'am that yes, the online education may be the convenient and the safest, but it is not the only mode. We need to have one-to-one, face-to-face, person-to-person interaction, teacher-student learning needs to be more intensified and integrated. And I totally agree that we cannot give the standardized process of evaluation to all. It needs to be customized. It needs to be taken into consideration. Who are the different forms of, what are the different levels of the students with whom we need to enter into the process of evaluation? I would thank ma'am that when we came into the picture of COVID-19, the Higher Education and Technical Education Department of the Government of Gujarat, along with the ministers, was very active in giving guidelines to the universities and the education institutions. And when we were trying to find out ways and means how to go on with the sessions, even in COVID-19, COVID at that point of time, with all the alertness which the Higher and Technical Education has shown, I put it into the acronym in the form C stands for, you know, connectivity, how ma'am very aptly connected with all the institutions and the universities across Gujarat. O stands for online content, how the emphasis was laid on creating an online content for the students even at this point of time. V stands for virtual classroom. We shifted to Zoom, we shifted to Microsoft Teams, and we shifted to online conferences. I stands for, we still maintain the interface happening between the student and the teacher, but yes, it is going through virtual process. And then D, we need to also create the teaching material, reference material, notes for the students on a digital storage platform. So this COVID-19 has also given the new perspective for teachers like us. And thank you very much, ma'am, for guiding us during this time, and looking forward for your suggestions in the future too. Thank you.